This is not stock. And this is the down pressure.
Uh-huh. Yep.
For your press wheels. And this is your depth wheel, right? So we put new cutting discs. Obviously these are for cutting into sod. But then we got new heavy duty cut discs. And then the spring and the side shank that does the gauge, this is a new. This is aftermarket as well.
So where did you get these parts to retrofit?
This is all out of that one, what's the name of that catalog? Everybody's got it. If it was in the air, you could see the hammers on this sucker. What's great about this is cover cropping. Like, you know, sometimes like, you know, you're like, oh, I gotta really manage that cover crop before it's out of hand. Or you couldn't, like, I would not grow Sudan grass here.
Yeah.
Because it was like, we can't do anything. I can never get rid of it. I can't mow it. It just like swirls around and clogs up my brush hog. A good flail mower, boy, you can grow different cover crops. You can grow on just your bed system and just take the flail out and just mow that bed and then incorporate just that one. Plus it makes it, you know, like so fine that like it incorporates better into the ground for like, you know, like those fine seeded crops and stuff. The other thing is with this and the no-till planter, I don't plow for corn at all. I mow down my cover crop or I crimp it, I wait a little bit, I go in, no-till, cover crop stands back up, we flail right to the ground, and it doesn't catch up to the corn after that. And okay. Like, I got funny looking corn that like the corn's this high and I have like little rye stubble that's like this high. But I'm like, I don't know. Throw a little extra fertility down.
Yeah, that's fine. Like, yeah.